Having seizures and epilepsy is very concerning, and the worst part is that you do not know when the next seizure is going to happen, and as a parent or a caregiver, you're worried about your loved one if they are having seizures and you're not able to be there and help them. Well, now luckily we have new technologies I will talk to you about today that will be able to alarm you and let you know when your child or somebody is having a seizure, so that you will be able to provide the help that they need, and hopefully we will prevent the dreaded complication of sudden unexpected death in epilepsy or SUDEP. Today I'll be reviewing the available technologies for seizure detections and these watches that I tried myself and prescribed for my own patient. And make sure to stick until the end because I have a surprise and giveaway for you. And I had the privilege to talk to Dr. Gregory Krause from Johns Hopkins Hospital, and he is one of the world experts on seizure detection.
And one of the reasons that people want this is about 1 in 500 people per year can potentially have sudden unexpected death in epilepsy in patients with uncontrolled seizures. And there's been a strong association between SUDEP, sudden unexpected death in epilepsy, and having tonic-clonic seizures. And there have been a lot of studies of this. There's a lot of interest in this in our epilepsy community. And the mobile device may provide a way to alert caregivers of someone having a tonic-clonic seizures and assist them and potentially prevent, you know, this complication. Well, there's several types of devices that have been explored. The first one that was approved in the U.S. was a EMG patch device that would detect EMG changes associated with tonic-clonic seizures. That device was not commercially successful and is no longer being marketed. A second device that came along is called the Embrace Watch, and it's a specialty watch that detects tonic-clonic seizures. And it uses electrodermal response, heart rate, and movements to pattern changes that are associated with tonic-clonic seizures. And so the idea is you get this watch, you pay a monthly subscription fee, and it will detect tonic-clonic seizures and message caregivers.
Interestingly, about half of the seizures go undetected by the patients themselves and they do not report them. We have seen it many times and we have done studies in the epilepsy monitoring unit. The patients comes in for their seizures and then they will have a big major seizure, and after the seizure ends, we ask them a question, did you have a seizure? And half of the time they will say no. And this is not a surprise because seizures happen in the memory area and it will cloud the memory, so you're not coding those experiences. So having a device that tells you when you had a seizure is invaluable. The perfect seizure detection device is a device that can tell you when you have seizures in more than 90% of the time. It does not give you false positive, means that alarm without a seizure. It is easy to use, has a long battery life. It is not expensive and it is not stigmatizing, means like you can wear it and blend in with other technologies and other things that we usually wear on daily basis. And people cared the most when we were asked about this, about the accuracy, being non-stigmatizing, and being easy to use. And to learn how these technologies and the watches work, let's discuss with Dr. Benjamin Brinkmann from Mayo Clinic, who was my mentor, and he is one of the people who is pioneering and advancing these technologies.
There are two devices that are FDA approved in the United States for detecting seizures. They both detect convulsive seizures or tonic-clonic seizures with the very typical pattern of movement. There's a wrist-worn device from a company called Empatica that has an accelerometer, and it has something that measures your skin conductance, and that's coupled with a system to provide alerts to a loved one or a caregiver. And then there's another device that sits over your muscle and it measures your muscle activity. Again, it's machine learning, artificial intelligence algorithms are looking for that very characteristic pattern of jerking movements. So it doesn't, you know, you don't get false alarms if you just move your arm or do normal. They're trained, the algorithms are trained on a vast database of seizures. And the reason it works is because these seizures are so similar between different patients. So they've recorded seizures from hundreds, if not maybe thousands of patients and shown these patterns to the algorithms
This video was not sponsored by any company who makes those watches. I did get the watches from the company and they gave me a free subscription just to test it out. The first watch is from company Empatica, the watch called Embrace 2. This watch, you can wear it on your hand. It comes as a seizure detection only watch. So it's not an app or anything. You have to buy the watch itself. It is comfortable and easy to use. You will have to buy the watch itself. It's priced right now at $249. And you have to get a prescription from your doctor so that hopefully it can be compensated by the insurance. They do not cover it upfront, but you can hopefully submit and get a refund. And this watch needs a monthly subscription. Plans start currently at $9.90 a month, and the plans can go higher with more features, and they do deliver outside the United States. My own experience with the watch was positive. I did wear it for every day and night, and it was comfortable to wear and sleep with. And it did go at the beginning one every 1 to 2 days with like movements, brushing my teeth or like carrying things because my hand would be tense, or like making a smoothie. I was like holding the mixer and that vibration caused the watch to go off. And then the watch is adaptive and it learns. There are algorithms that makes it learn from your seizures. So we'll say, was this a seizure or not? And then if it was not a seizure, it will kind of like start to discard those types of repetitive movements and learn more and more your specific seizure patterns. So as the days goes on, the watch was less and less making those like alarms, and I was not able to cheat the watch at the end of the testing period. So it looks like a solid solution for seizure detection, and you can get the watch and use it and try it out. There are like a free trial for using it, so you can use it. If you don't like it, you can return it to the company. The second solution I tried is SeizAlarm app. So I tried it because it's an app that incorporates with the Apple Watch. So it is installed on the Apple Watch and your own phone, the iPhone. And there are other solutions for the Galaxy and Android phones. This watch was way less sensitive. It was giving me alarms right and left multiple times a day with any like movements, repetition, carrying things. And it does give you an alarm before it calls somebody. It tells you like, was this a seizure or not? And if it was not a seizure, obviously you're aware of it. It will start vibrating and you turn it off, and that will not go through a call. And that is a good feature. And it does not, unfortunately, have algorithms that learns your patterns of the seizures, and it will log all those events that happens as seizures. And you can toggle down and up the sensitivity of the watch. You can decrease the sensitivity so that only big seizures will be detected, or if you increase the sensitivity, you will start having lots of false positive alarms without being having seizures. And they even can use the device itself, the iPhone in your pocket, as like a detection. But if you run and move with it, it can go off a lots of times. So it's always a balance. And I did talk to the people at SeizAlarm and the engineering team, and I suggested that they implement those machine learning algorithms so that they can adapt and learn from the seizures and the false alarms, so that they will get better and better with time. A major limitation of all watches for seizures is that will depend on movement a lot to detect seizures. And we know that about more than half of the seizures do not include aggressive movements, such as like just pausing or like focal aware impaired awareness seizures. Like you just lose awareness without shaking necessarily, like absence seizures in children, and so many other types of seizures that do not involve aggressive shaking. The future is bright for wearable devices technology.
I think wearable devices in the future are only going to be more prevalent. They're going to be, I think they have great potential to really help people who are struggling with seizures. New devices keep coming up quite quickly. You know, I think right now there are quite a few engineering challenges with the devices that we have, but engineering challenges can be solved. And I think companies and research labs are working on that.
So what watch I would recommend? So at this point, there is an explosion of the amount of solutions and watches and devices other than just like the watch. There are like cameras that detect motion. You can put it in the room. You can have like things under the mattress. Lots of solutions. And the FDA is always coming up with the new updates and a new approval. So check that first. And then also check with your own doctor what is the best watch that or seizure detection they would recommend, because they know your seizures the best. At this point, I would recommend the Empatica 2 seizure detection watch because it is the most reliable one and gives you the least amount of false positives, and it is the most accurate solution right now. However, this could change really quickly in the future, so stay tuned for any changes on those devices and if anything comes to the market. All right, now is a surprise. So this is the watch. This is the Empatica 2 watch that I tested myself, and I would like to give it to you. So the only thing you need to do is that you fill the link down in the description with your information, and if you are the lucky winner, I will ship that to your own house and get this watch for you or your loved one. And if your seizures are poorly controlled with medications, this means that this might be a drug-resistant epilepsy. And this is a special type of epilepsy when seizures do not work and we need to do other treatments for epilepsy and seizures, which include surgical treatments such as surgical resection or implanting new devices. And all of these I explained in details in this video. For all the information that you need about drug-resistant epilepsy, and stay healthy and see you in the next one. Salam.